Whether you rock sideburns or baby smooth legs, all shavers alike share one thing in common: the existential threat of razor sharp metal. Razor burn and nicks and cuts are enough to make some folks go full lumberjack, but for the rest of us, shaving cream packs the custom chemistry needed to keep our precious skin safe from harm. What is this miracle substance, you ask? Today, with the help of our friend Ms. Beautyphile, we're taking a closer look at this chemically incredible foam. People have been shaving for thousands of years. It's said that Alexander the Great had his soldiers shave to stop beard pulling in battle. But later on in the 1940s, when beard trimming was less of a military strategy, brush and mug shaving soaps were used to whip up a foam that helped make the process a lot smoother. Then in 1949, a game changer hit the market. Aerosol shaving cream was a smooth-faced revolution, bringing new levels of convenience and efficiency to the table. Shaving cream does a lot more than just lubricate your face to prevent nicks and cuts. Its dense foam and tiny bubbles lift hair away from your skin for a closer shave, while also telling you where your razor's been. And lastly, it gets your face nice and clean, because shaving cream is actually just soap in a can. But chemically speaking, it's a soap with a lot of thought put into it. Miss Beautyphile, why don't you give us a hand and explain how?
Soaps belong to a class of molecules called surfactants that have the ability to hold on to water and oil at the same time. Here's an example of what they look like. There's a fatty acid on one side with a zigzagging tail and a positive ion on the other. One side is hydrophilic, meaning it loves water, and the other side is hydrophobic, which means it doesn't like water, but it's attracted to oil. It's this special quality that allows surfactants to scoop up oily dirt and whisk it away with water, getting you squeaky clean. So if it's just soap, then why can't we splash some water on our face and do this to get a nice foam to shave with? You'll notice the bubbles from the bar soap dissolve almost immediately. One of the reasons shaving soaps are so much better at creating that long-lasting foam is that they're formulated for optimal lather. When it comes to creating great lather, part of the equation is the ion in the hydrophilic head. A sodium or potassium ion will give you a less dense, lacier foam, while triethanolamine will give you a creamier lather, which is why triethanolamine is the preferred choice when it comes to shaving cream formulations. The other secret to a good lather involves picking the right fatty acid for the job, because the length of a fatty acid tail greatly impacts the texture of the soap. Lauric acid here has only 12 carbons, which is short by shaving cream standards. Because the tail is so short, its hydrophilic head has more influence over the molecule, allowing it to hold on to water better. This creates a generous lather and tons of tiny bubbles. But the problem is, these bubbles aren't structurally sound on their own, so shaving cream manufacturers may add in some longer chain fatty acids to help the bubbles survive longer on the job. Here is an example. Stearic acid has a whopping 18 carbons, making it much longer than lauric acid. That extra length gives the hydrophobic tail far more influence over the molecule's head, making it much less soluble in water. It's this insolubility that adds stability to the bubbles. Now, if we take stearic acid and combine it with triethanolamine, we get a particular flavor of soap called triethanolamine stearate. This is a popular ingredient in many shaving creams. The stearic acid helps the bubbles keep their structure, while the triethanolamine gives you the copious bubbles necessary to cover your face and helps give you that perfect shave. But we're forgetting the most important innovation that makes the soapy mixture into a magical foam: pressure. Inside a can of shaving cream, our soapy ingredients are packaged under pressure together with a propellant such as isobutane. When you press the button, you release the pressure, causing the propellant to expand. That expansion causes the contents to whoosh up the straw and out of the can. But the gaseous propellant is also the source of bubbles. So as the soapy goo escapes its pressurized prison, it also becomes a bubbly foam.
Thanks for filling us in, Ms. Beautyphile. There's a couple of other things going on in many shaving foam formulations too. They may contain skin softeners like glycerol, which help make up for the effects of some of the harsher soap molecules, and often there are added fragrances depending on the manufacturer's whims. You know, we love us some chemistry here at Reactions, but you don't have to be a chem PhD to understand the science behind cosmetics. Head over to Ms. Beautyphile on Facebook or YouTube if you want to learn more. Thanks for tuning in. If you find any other household products that you want us to dig into, post your questions down in the comments and we'll try to get back to you. Don't forget to hit thumbs up and subscribe on the way out, and we'll see you again soon.